This video provides demonstrations of division involving decimals, as well as an understanding of the long division algorithm, and taught in a way that provides activities for students. A decimal divided by a whole number, such as 45 hundredths divided by 3, can be illustrated by students shading a blank decimal square. First, shade the square for 45 hundredths. 44, 45. Then pose a word problem. If 45 hundredths of a pint of glycerol is shared equally by 3 people for a science experiment, how much glycerol will each person receive? Here is one of the many ways to divide the shaded amount of the square into 3 equal parts. Since each part has 15 hundredths, 45 hundredths divided by 3 equals 15 hundredths. And each person will receive 15 hundredths of a pint of glycerol. Here is another example of dividing a decimal by a whole number. If 9/10 of an acre of land is divided into 2 equal parts, one of these is what part of an acre? We start with shading a blank decimal square for 9/10. The first tenth and the last tenth. To divide the shaded amount into 2 equal parts, we can divide 8/10 by 2 to get 4/10 in each part with 1/10 remaining. Then we can replace the 1/10 by 10/100, and 10/100 divided by 2 is 5/100. So 9/10 divided by 2 is 4/10 and 5/100, or 45/100. So each part is 45/100 of an acre. Or we could replace the 9/10 square by 90/100, and 90/100 divided by 2 is 45/100. The algorithm for computing 9/10 divided by 2 is similar to the steps we use with the 9/10 square. We start with 4/10, just like we divided the square, into 2 parts of 4/10. 4/10 times 2 is 8, 8/10, but we don't use the decimal point, and 9/10 minus 8/10 is 1/10. Then we place a 0, because 9/10 is equal to 90/100, and we bring down the 0 to get 10/100. Then 10/100 divided by 2 is 5/100, we put that in the hundredths place, and 5 times 2 is 10, to complete the algorithm. The shaded amount of this 20/100 square is 4 times bigger than the shaded amount of this 5/100 square. We can show this by dividing the 20/100 square into 4 equal parts with a water-based pen so the lines can be washed off. So 20/100 divided by 5/100 equals 4. Or we could say the shaded amount of the 500 square fits into the shaded amount of the 20/100 square 4 times. Note that this division was done with just whole numbers. The 20 small parts in this square were divided by the 5 small parts in this square. Let's look at the algorithm for computing 20/100 divided by 5/100. First, we move the decimal point in the divisor to make the divisor a whole number. Then we move the decimal point in the dividend the same number of places. Then we divide as if dividing by whole numbers. 5 goes into 20 4 times, and 4 times 5 is 20, to complete the algorithm. If the altitude of a science balloon was 3 6/10 miles, and the altitude of a second balloon is 1 2/10 miles, how many times higher is the first balloon? These 3 unit squares and 6/10 square represent the 3 6/10 miles altitude of the first balloon. And this unit square and 2/10 square represent the 1 2/10 miles altitude of the second balloon. We can see that the single unit square fits into the 3 unit squares 3 times. And the shaded amount of the 2/10 square fits into the shaded amount of the 6/10 square 3 times. So 3 6/10 divided by 1 2/10 equals 3. And so the altitude of the first balloon is 3 times higher. Notice that we could find this quotient by dividing whole numbers. 10, 20, 30, 6, 36 parts, divided by 10 and 2, 12 parts, and 36 divided by 12 equals 3. Let's look at the algorithm for dividing 3 6/10 by 1 2/10. First, remove the decimal point in the divisor to make it a whole number. And also, we need to move the decimal point in the dividend the same number of places to the right. Then, 36 divided by 12 is 3, and 3 times 12 is 36. And that completes the algorithm. When dividing by decimals, we always move the decimal point in the divisor so that we end up dividing by a whole number. In this example, moving the decimal point one place in the divisor and one place in the dividend is like multiplying both numbers by 10. And this does not change the quotient. Let's look at another example of dividing a mixed decimal by a mixed decimal. Suppose a rectangle has one dimension of 1 8/10 and contains 4 unit squares and 14 hundredths. What is the missing dimension of the rectangle? If we complete the rectangle with these 5 pieces, we will have the missing dimension. We start by placing 2 unit squares on the grid, and then we have to cut the last 2 unit squares into 8/10 2/10. And the 8/10 pieces can be placed on the grid. This leaves 2 4/5/10 4/100 that can be used to complete the end of the rectangle. So the missing dimension, 2 3/10. And we record this dimension. And 4 14/100 divided by 1 8/10 equals 2 3/10. So we started with one dimension and the total number of squares for a rectangle, as shown in this diagram, and found the missing dimension. Notice that by removing these 2 sides of the diagram becomes the long division symbol. This connection from a rectangle to the long division symbol could be helpful to students. The first step in dividing is to move the decimal point in the divisor to make it a whole number, and move the decimal point in the dividend the same number of places. Then we carry out the division algorithm, as shown here, to obtain the quotient 2 3/10. You have seen visual demonstrations involving division of decimals. Together with a few word problems, to help provide understanding for making division meaningful. The rectangular grid in the last demonstration of this video shows a close relationship between division and multiplication. One of the eight games from decimalsquares.com that is related to this lesson is laser beams. The first operation is division, and the shot was successful. Another successful shot. This person knows what they're doing.